So Dakmasai is a first-person action game set in the world of Might and Magic. The main focus of the game is really the freedom of expression for the player. We really want to make sure that the players don't feel like they're playing in a game that's been, you know, set up by a designer and they didn't have the choice to really do what they did. So we just giving them tools to express themselves and find, you know, creative ways to bypass challenges and to kill enemies, finish the game, and so that's the main focus. So a very good example of that would be at the end of the demo that we have here. You have this huge cyclop. This cyclop is really tough. It's really hard to kill, and the most sensitive point is the eye. So what you need to do is to find a way to bring him to his knees, or to make sure you can hit in the eye without him trying to protect it. So you can, for example, use your electrical spells to, you know, shoot on the water, and, you know, whenever he steps on the water, he's like all electrified, and, you know, he falls down on his knees, and, you know, you can just kill him, or, you know, you can shoot at stalactites, you know, on the cave that falls on him, so, you know, he gets stunned, falls, and, you know, you finish him off. You can destroy like something that you have a structure against the wall, which is a wooden platform that, you know, you attract him under that, you know, you kind of create a trap for him. And basically, actually, the whole environment in the game becomes a huge trap for your enemies. And the just little twist is actually sometimes, or most of the time, actually, they are aware of these traps and they can also use them against you. So you also have to be careful where you stand, and so it doesn't, you know, turn against you also. So the character will evolve throughout the game. So you'll begin as, you know, Sareth, who is a young apprentice, and he knows a bit of magic. He knows how to, you know, to fight with most weapons. And as the game goes, you know, you can get new skill points, and you will be able to decide yourself where you can spend your skill points. So you have more or less three main ways for the player to specialize in. You can become a warrior, you can become more of a mage, more of assassin, and you can mix and match as much as you want, actually. You can be a bit of everything, if that's up to you to decide. It's been great to work with Valve, actually. Been very lucky. Actually, it's they're giving us a lot of support to make sure that, I mean, that's normal. I mean, you know, they want the game to look good as much as we want, because, you know, it's another ambassador of their great technology. So they've been amazing. Each time, you know, we had some issues, they were always very eager to help, and sending people over when needed. People of our team from Arcane going to Valve's to also train, show the engine, see, you know, compare, see how, like, something is not good enough, so how we could improve it. They would bounce ideas, and very, very good support. So as you may know, the events in Dark Messiah occur 20 years after the events of Heroes 5. So this is a continuation of that story. There is a prophecy that says that there will be a Dark Messiah that will be able to open the door of the demons, so the demons will be able to crawl all over the world. That is something you will hear a bit about in Heroes 5. And now the day has come when this Dark Messiah may be coming to open the door. So you're going to have to more or less stop him. Your mentor, Fenric, who's been training you for all your life, will send you on a journey, and he will make a kind of alliance with the humans of the three cities. And with them, they will try to get an artifact to actually stop these three cities from crumbling under the assaults of another faction that are the Necromancers. So at first, you know, you are this young apprentice, you have all these things happening around you, you have, you know, this war between the humans and Necromancers, you have this prophecy about the Demon Lord, you know, coming over to this world. And at first you don't really quite understand, of course, what you have to do with all these things, but obviously you will realize where, you know, you stand in that plot. And throughout the game also you will have a few characters that will accompany you and help you out, like Xana. Xana is a little demon, succubus, and she's a very attractive and a very seductive woman, and she knows how to get her ways, and she will be actually sent within you, and so you will be schizophrenic sometimes. And so it's very interesting how she will have her own views of things, of some events and elements that maybe the player will have other views on. So it's very interesting, this combination between the two. Then you have also other characters that will lead you through the end of the game, like Lyanna, who's a young little wizard that will help you out. And still to go on, or, you know, and this feeling of freedom that we want to give the player himself will be able to decide the ending of the game. It's not like, for example, Oblivion, that is, or World of Warcraft, which is huge world, huge environment, and you can go wherever you want. But in another way, when you have to do a quest, you have to go through certain steps, and that's it. For us, it's very different. It's structure, which is much more in line with Half-Life 2. It's like you have level 1 and level 2. But within these levels, this is where we very differentiate from other shooters, is you don't have a single path, a single way of finishing the game. You have this different path that you can take, you can find alternative ways, you can go around the fight, you don't have to always fight. And killing your enemies is not the only way to solve things in the game. You have so many different ways, and as you don't get experience for killing, you get them, you know, for just bypassing the challenge, so just going somewhere else. So it's freedom within the level of movement, of action, of choices, but this level will be played one after the other. So the game is being developed by Arkane Studio for the single player in Lyon and by Kudju for the multiplayer in London. So it's we have roughly 40 people in Lyon, we have like 12 people that are based in London for that, and another 10 people in Paris to help out both teams. So the multiplayer also, it's a big part of the game. Multiplayer, we want to give also this thing of evolution that you have in single player, so we wanted to find that back also in multiplayer. So you'll be able to play a class which is different from the single player. This time you will have to, you'll be able to tell your teammates, okay, I'm going to be playing a warrior and I'm going to be having the role of a healer, whatever it is. And then you're going to gain experience, you know, throughout killing your enemies or, you know, conquering territories. And you will go up in level, become stronger, get, you know, new abilities, new skills, new ways to stop enemies' attacks or to attack or kill someone else differently. So you find back, once again, this kind of idea of, you know, evolutions and rock, paper, scissors that you have in a single player. It's very action-focused, but with a strong team-based element and strategy kind of in thinking how you guys, you know, fight to destroy the enemy team or, you know, win the map. The game will be released end of September on PC, and really hope you will enjoy it.